Hello, it's Laura Heydrich with the Pain Cure Clinic, where we teach people how to permanently cure chronic pain. And check out our free guide to diagnosing and curing chronic pain on our website at paincureclinic.us. There's a link below. So in this episode, I'm going to show you how your personality may be causing your chronic pain, and then I'm going to show you what to do to stop that from happening. First, I want to introduce a very common and often primary cause of stress and chronic conditions, regardless of how your specific issues are manifesting, whether it's classic back pain, joint pain, irritable bowel syndrome, a skin condition, or some combination of these, among many others. What I'm talking about is your perfectionism. And the reason I say that I'm just introducing this topic is because perfectionism has many tentacles. It can be like an octopus with multiple arms that overlap and get tangled and keep you trapped in a mindset that generates chronic pain. Please hang with me because I know what some of you are thinking right now. You're saying to yourself, I just like to plan and be organized, to fulfill my responsibilities, to be liked and help others, to be my best, and yes, even to win. My perfectionism has made me successful in life. What's wrong with that? Nothing. Until you take some or all of these things too far and put too much pressure on yourself and sometimes other people. Pressure that rarely or never eases up. I'm going to give you three tactics for changing the way you think about perfectionism that will help you start getting a handle on this. But first, let's take a moment and look at a basic definition. What is perfectionism? Perfectionism is the relentless pursuit of an impossible state of perfection related to your life events, your relationships, how you wish to be perceived by others, the need to win or be the best, or all of the above. And consider this, perfectionism can become a sort of addiction, can it? Doing things perfectly can lead to some good stuff. Recognition and respect, getting a promotion, making more money, winning the race, and scoring that trophy. But perfectionism can also lead to tension and pain. You don't have to become a full-blown slacker to avoid chronic pain, but you do need to acknowledge that there is such a thing as going overboard with your high standards. So what to do? Well, first, own it. You've got to become aware that perfectionism is a problem for you and take an honest look at where you fall on the perfectionism scale. We simply can't fix what we don't acknowledge. And it can be hard to see this in ourselves. We're used to how we are. The quickest way to get your head out of the sand is to ask your partner or someone else close to you if they think that your perfectionism is a problem. And then give them permission to give you a true answer without getting defensive. My guess is that many of you won't even need to pose this question because this issue has already come up repeatedly. I can relate. John and I still have the "you're being too much of a perfectionist" about this conversation on a semi-regular basis. But I have gotten a lot better at dialing it back to the point that I have no chronic pain. You can too. The second step is to flip it. By flip it, I mean switch your perspective and visualize a situation where you're pointing out perfectionist tendencies to a friend, coworker, or loved one. Ironically, we are often able to see behaviors in other people that we can't or don't want to see in ourselves. For example, I had a boss once who proofread and re-edited sales copy to the point that we would miss the printing deadline. And that created tension for the entire department. Be the inner voice of reason and don't drive yourself crazy by overanalyzing the details. The world will truly not end if a comma is out of place, or even if, God forbid, there's one typo. And the third tactic is to prioritize it. Recently, one of our coaching clients had an aha moment and stated, "I'm no longer bringing my A game to bullshit endeavors." Well said. I felt that statement all the way down to my toes, and I hope you really take her words to heart as well. Perfectionist friends, you have to start prioritizing your intensity. And please notice that the word tense is part of intensity. There are certainly situations where we need to be as precise as possible. If you're a brain surgeon, please bring your A game to my procedure. But most things that most of us do on a daily basis are not this critical. When you feel your tension rising because something isn't perfect or unfolding according to your plan, apply a priority filter and ask yourself, is what's happening right now really worth getting riled up about? What price will I pay? If you have chronic pain, you already know the answer. And that's the main takeaway from this video. Your perfectionism is causing your pain. I'll wrap up our time together today by assuring you that we're not suggesting that you try to completely change wonderful you. That's not even possible or necessary. We're talking about a dialing back over time that will lead to less pressure, less tension, and less chronic pain. It's a practice of choosing progress, not perfection. Progress, not perfection. I bought the t-shirt I'm wearing today with that very phrase on the front at a yoga studio as a reminder that yoga, just like life, is a practice and that executing perfect poses is not the goal. Give your mind and your body a break and stop trying to be perfect. And if you haven't already, be sure to hit the subscribe button below so you won't miss more great content coming soon. In the meantime, we'd love to hear from you. How has perfectionism affected your life? And what one step can you take today to moderate your behavior? Post a comment below. Thanks, and I'll be back soon.